I want to thank everybody for coming out. Obviously, with our missing persons cases, it is the media and the community that helps us solve these cases. Behind you, you will see the vehicle that belongs to Rnic Sr. This vehicle is his and his only. So we believe that on December the 1st is the last time that he was actually seen. And sometime between December 2nd and December 3rd, the vehicle was involved in some type of altercation and or accident up here that caused the vehicle to go off on the roadway. Our counterparts at Nevada Highway Patrol confirmed that with their officers that go back and forth from Mountain Pass. We believe that somebody, whether it's a resident of Las Vegas or somebody in Pahrump that makes their journey back and forth, saw this vehicle or saw somebody, asked somebody if they needed help, either the occupants, the driver, somebody in that vehicle. So today our main goal is to really get press out there to see if somebody can jog their memories 3 weeks before Christmas if they saw this vehicle. This vehicle, we believe, is key to the investigation, and I will say it's an ongoing investigation. We do have evidence to believe that foul play may have occurred, so we believe that time is of the essence for us. In saying that, this vehicle, the citizens that drive these roads are going to be key to solving this.
Sergeant, of all the missing persons cases you've had in your career, what made this one stick out to you and to the department to have this press conference? Why is this case so unique?
Well, I've been in missing persons for 9 years now. We've done similar cases like this with the Cole Puffenberger case and several other cases. The unique thing about this is we had detectives thinking outside the box and racking their brains, because when a detective gets a case like this, they really live it. It consumes them, consumes their personal life. And we had forward-thinking detectives that said, hey, is there anything wrong with taking that vehicle out of evidence, making sure our chain of custody is proper, and placing it back up there and see if we have somebody from our community that would jog their memory? I think that's great forward thinking.
We can see the fingerprint testing on the vehicle. Were the detectives able to recover any other fingerprints?
Like I said, it's an ongoing investigation, but we've got great information, evidence, that I will not go into right now, but like I said, we believe he might have met foul play.
I mean, you've dealt with other issues like the Opal Parsons case and other things. And, you know, in my time here, I never remember you guys reenacting, or maybe you didn't tell us. Can you tell us who this victim is? Is he someone special? Is there something we need to know about his lifestyle that would cause you all to do that?
Well, I tell you, every citizen here in Nevada is special to us. Is he somebody that you guys don't know of? Absolutely not. He is a hardworking Romanian gentleman that is an avid soccer player, so maybe somebody in the soccer world sees this and jogs their memory. But is this case any different? I don't think so. I think with this time we had a forward-thinking detective. We've never had an accident scene like this that I can remember. So for us to use our counterparts at Nevada Highway Patrol, some very good crime scene / accident investigators, kind of tell us how that vehicle left the roadway. We know that the road up here at that time was icy on December 1st through the 2nd. We know that our victim was last seen on the 1st. So between the 2nd and the 3rd, that vehicle was up here. Why? We don't know. And there's the missing question.
You don't know if he was headed to Pahrump, or we heard he had a residence in Pahrump at one time.
Well, we do know through some offline searches that he maybe obtained some property up there. That's pure speculation now. We're going through archives on that. But we do believe through our counterparts at Nevada Highway Patrol and our resident officers that he was coming back into town. So that would make him traveling down the hill.
So was there another vehicle involved?
Well, see, that's what we're asking you to put out there. Was there another vehicle that was tandem with him? Was there a vehicle that maybe bumped him off the road? We don't have any indication on our car to prove that. We got great accident investigators through Nevada Highway Patrol. We think we've eliminated that, but we don't know if there was a time where the driver might have got scared by somebody over correcting on the road. You just don't know.
Was he, what did he do for a living?
He was an entrepreneur, sold tons of things. He was a gentleman that bargains back and forth with properties. You know, he's somebody that is out there working hard every day. That I don't know, and that's mere speculation. Really wouldn't matter.
Was he driving, or was someone else driving?
Well, that, you know what, that's the key. We cannot place him in this vehicle, but it is his vehicle. His ownership to the vehicle through Nevada Highway Patrol. There is no other family members that should be driving this vehicle. So we would love to assume that our victim was in this vehicle.
Was it any reason to believe it was stolen?
Oh, no reason at all.
Okay. Now here's something that had no license.
And we've talked to family members, and it's probably just going to be a matter of registering it when he had purchased it. That I wouldn't be able to give you.
What family does he have? A wife, children?
I'm not able to get into that.
So if you can't place him in the vehicle, mm-hmm. but you do have other fingerprints?
It's an ongoing investigation, and
so is there reason to believe he was in the car and taken from the car?
Well, that's the deal with missing persons cases, is you don't know. And a reenactment like this, something to jog our community members' memories through the media, obviously is key to us.
But I'm saying there's a disconnect, and yeah. if there was foul play involved, but you can't place him in the vehicle, that's kind of
Well, with any homicide case or evidentiary case, our missing persons detectives really recover people. So that's a person that's alive or dead. We're only assuming at this point, and it's mere speculation, that he might have met foul play, he might have been in the vehicle. We just don't know those things. So that's what we really need the community to jog their memories. If somebody was driving on this road, did they see somebody get out of the van that maybe isn't the same description as our victim? Those are things that are unknown.
I have two questions.
Area was searched. Yeah. Sorry.
That's exactly.
We had a pretty extensive search up here with our dogs, with our missing persons detectives, our helicopter detail. All those things occurred a couple weeks ago, and we've pretty much eliminated everything. Obviously, it would be key for us to know of any other extended family and or friends out there that might have known our victim to come forward, to contact us at 828-LOST, which is our direct number into the missing persons detail. That'll be manned for the next 24 hours with a recording and or a detective retrieving those messages. Any information that somebody may have, whether you think it's important or not, we need it.